What's up guys, welcome to our channel Etechniz. In this video we will talk about how to fix Assassin grid Odyssey unable to load library dbdata.dll error. I'll tell you all the steps to fix this problem, along with that the things you have to do to fix it. So stay tuned and watch the complete video. Before going further, if you are new to this channel, then click on subscribe button, select all on the bell notification, give a thumbs up if you like this video, and leave your feedback in the comment section. Step 1. Login to administrator account. As you all know, troubleshooting steps need the administrator permission every time whenever you're gonna move any file or you're gonna perform any kind of troubleshooting in Windows. So it's really important for you to be in your administrator account so that it will not show you a prompt that it cannot be done and you have to use the administrator account password every time. To check the account, click on Windows icon, click on Settings, here click on Accounts. As you can see the information in here, the name of the account Etechniz, it's a local account and with the administrator right. So I can perform all the troubleshooting as I have the administrator control on this account. If you do not have the administrator control, then you'll see standard instance of administrator in there. So make sure you check this thing before you perform all the troubleshooting step. Step 2. Turn off Windows security and antivirus. It has been updated on tech forum that Windows security or any other antivirus causes some problem while you changing the configuration of your Windows. Sometime it happen and in some cases it does not happen. So you have to turn it off so that you'll not get the problem. And along with that, you can try to do this troubleshooting with having these antivirus and Windows security on. You can do either of the way, you can try it. If the setting and the configuration you're gonna set up on your PC work perfectly with having antivirus, then you do not have to turn it off. If not, then you have to turn it off the Windows security. To turn off the Windows security, click on Windows icon, click on Setting, here click on Update and Security. On the left hand side, as you can see Windows Security, click on it. Here as you can see Virus and Threat Protection, click on it. Once you'll be on this page Virus and Threat Protection, click on Manage Settings. You have to turn this option off. It asks your permission, UAC control, click yes. And that's how you have to turn off Windows Security. There is a one more way to turn off Windows security completely. For that you have to open the PowerShell. To open the PowerShell, click on Windows icon, type in here PowerShell, click on Run as administrator. It asks the permission, click on yes. Here you have to paste a command. I have updated the command in the description so you can copy it from there. The command is this one, set my preference disable real-time monitoring true. Copy this command and paste it in here and press enter. Now as the Windows security turned off, after this you have to turn off the antivirus. As you are the home user, you might have the antivirus on your PC. To turn off the antivirus on your PC, click on this upside arrow. You'll find the antivirus listed in here. Do a right click. You'll see the option to disable your antivirus. Disable it for 1 hour or till the time you run it again. If all the troubleshooting work perfectly fine with having your antivirus and Windows security on, you do not have to perform this step, or if it does not work, then you can turn off your antivirus. Step 3. Create CPY.ini configuration setting file. In here I can show you a link, by that you can download this file. However, I like to show you how you can create this CPY.ini file. You just have to do a right click on your desktop, click on new, you'll see text document, and in there you have to paste the command. As you can see the text document, the same I have in here. So if I'll open this, I have the command already saved in here. I'll update that command in the description. Once you'll paste the command in the notepad, click on file, click on save as, select the desktop and type here cpy.ini. As I already have this on my desktop, so I'm creating the another one, so I'm adding number 2 in here. After this you have to select all file from save as type and then click on save. As you can see the new file is created. So that's how you have to create the cpy.ini file. Step 4. Download dbdata.dll and uplay underscore r1 underscore loader64.dll files. For to download these DLL files, open the Google Chrome or any other browser you have. On the address bar, type tejadvice.com/safe-search. You'll be on this page, or either you can type the website name tejadvice.com, and in the footer of the website you'll find safe search. You just have to click on safe search and you'll be on this page. Now here, first you have to type download dbdata.dll and click search. As you can see the file in here, dbdata.dll free download. So open this file. You'll be on this page. In here, as you can see, it says architecture 64. They do not have any other architecture, so I'm not gonna explain you how you can check your system type. Click on download. As you can see, this file is downloaded on my Chrome browser. Let me show you that. As you can see, it's downloaded right now. After this, you have to download the another file which says uplay underscore r1 underscore loader64.dll file. So type in here that file name and click on the search. As you can see, it's listed in here, uplay underscore r1 loader64.dll free download. It have to be on the website of dllfiles.com. Open it. Now scroll it down. The same thing is here, you do not have to check your system type because all of the files in here are 64-bit version. So download the latest one. Click on download. Alright, both of them are downloaded now. Now what you have to do, this file cpy.in and the two DLL files you have downloaded on your PC, you have to paste it on the folder, which is our step 5. Paste all file in Assasins Creed Odyssey folder. To open that folder, press the Windows icon and E on your keyboard. Click on this PC. Click on local disk. Here, click on program files. You'll find this folder, Assasins Creed Odyssey. Open this folder. Here, you have to paste this file. Copy this file and paste it in here. Do a right click on the file and click on copy, and do a right click in the folder and click on paste. Your PC will ask the administrator permission. Click on continue. Now go to the download folder. You have to unzip both of the file. Do a right click on the file and click extract all. This one is extracted. We have to extract the other one. Now as we have extracted both of the DLL files, you have to go back to the same place. Click on this PC, local disk, program files x86, Assasins Creed Odyssey, copy this file, do a right click, click copy and paste it in here. Click continue. Do the same thing with this file. Do a right click, click on copy, do a right click and paste it in here. Click continue. That's how you have to paste both of the file. After this, try to open your Assassin's Creed Odyssey game. It will surely come up. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.